Nutrition during pregnancy is a learning curve. And then you add in running and it adds a whole new dimension. Today, I'm going to be talking about 3 tips for fueling yourself as a pregnant runner. I'm Kristy, a registered dietitian located in Minnesota. I'm a mom to a 2-year-old and baby number 2 on the way. I help runners learn how to fuel your body well without feeling stressed or anxious or obsessed with food, but learning to be in tune and listen to your body. Tip number 1 is eat consistently throughout the day. As a pregnant woman, your blood sugar levels can drop quickly, especially in second and third trimester. So having consistent meals, eating consistently throughout the day is going to be super important in order to prevent those blood sugars from going up after eating and then dropping down and becoming too low, where you feel like lightheaded, nausea, get headaches. So make sure, like, when you have a meal to eat, when you have a snack, try to include both a carbohydrate and a protein. Apple and peanut butter, cheese and crackers, a piece of fruit and a handful of nuts. These are all good examples that will help stabilize your blood sugar for a longer period of time. Tip number 2 is hydration is important. As a pregnant woman, your blood volume expands by about 50%. This means your body needs to stay hydrated. It needs more fluids. And as a pregnant runner as well, you might notice sweating quicker. You might know yourself sweating more because of your body temperature rising, and you need to regulate your body temperature. That's what sweating provides. And so naturally, you're going to lose more fluid loss and increase the risk of dehydration. So hydrating, not only like during your run, after your run, but everyday hydration is important. Making sure that you're adequately, you know, drinking enough water throughout the day, so then once you go out for a run, your body is already properly hydrated, and it'll help manage not only your body temperature, but prevent dehydration and negative effects that can come as a result. For example, cramping is one of those. Plan a running route that has quick access to bathrooms, because we know baby likes to push on the bladder and you are going to the bathroom a lot more often. And adding the dimension of drinking more water just adds those frequent bathroom breaks. Tip number 3 is stick to those sports nutrition guidelines. This is where eating before, during, after your run becomes even more important while you're pregnant to, again, help manage that blood sugar, help make sure that you're hydrated throughout the time that you're running, and make sure that you're feeling well. So before you go out for a run, you might find that it's even more important to have carbohydrates to eat, whether it's a banana, a piece of bread with jelly on it, a fig bar, dried fruit. There's kind of endless options. If you have a little bit more time before you go out for a run, like let's say 1 hour, 2 hours, adding protein with that snack will help again stabilize those blood sugars so it doesn't spike and then drop quickly. The protein helps to stabilize the blood sugars. Now, during your run, you might find yourself needing something to eat for sure if you're running 45 minutes to 1 hour. To help again stabilize those blood sugars and give yourself energy. And then after your run, refueling right away with both carbohydrates and protein, whether it's a smoothie or chocolate milk, or again, a banana and peanut butter are a great option. If you found this helpful, I would love for you to come join me on marathon.nutritionist on Instagram, where I share all sorts of fueling tips for runners to help you have a healthy relationship with food, learn how to fuel your body confidently as a runner, and so you can become a stronger, faster runner and feel your best.